So guys, we are discussing Canadian immigration at its full length today. This is a video that you must be watching if you are interested in coming to Canada. What is a PR? What is a TRB? What is it that we are looking at, or the Canadian immigration government is looking at when you want to come to Canada? So this is the video if you want to come to Canada and you have no information, no details whatsoever, but you still have a dream that Canada is a great nation and you should be living here. So if that is your dream, then this is the video that you must be watching. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant. So guys, welcome back once again. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant. I am a member of ICCRC and I practice here inside Canada. My office is here in Ontario. Guys, before we start this video, I need to tell you that if you need to reach out to me, please feel free to drop in a line, a WhatsApp message, or give us a call on our number which is in the description box or on the website wherever you find this video. Also, we will get in touch with you once we get time to do so. Guys, if you are watching this video or if you are seeing me first time on the internet or through any other channel, please feel free to subscribe to this channel. Also, hit the bell icon because we talk about Canadian immigration on this channel all the time. We share all delivery related updates, all updates of IRCC, any program. So if you want to be updated regarding that information, then this is the video that you must be watching and you can get in touch with us like I said before. So guys, before anything else, let's just quickly start this video and get to the basic topic that if you know nothing about Canadian immigration, if you are totally starting from the scratch ABC of immigration, then this video is going to tell you everything about that. So guys, one thing that you must know is the short abbreviations or the various companies or the agencies or the government involved. What do we name them? And you will come across these words quite often every now and then. So the first word that you're looking at, the first letters that you're looking at is called IRCC. That's the Immigration, Refugees and Citizenship Canada. That is the Immigration Department of Canada. That's a short form to it. That's called IRCC. So all the applications are sent to IRCC. All the communication is received from IRCC when it comes to your visitor visas, your TRVs, your PR applications or anything else. So IRCC is the main department that deals with your applications when you want to immigrate to Canada. The second and the equally important company, the agency that you're looking at, the Immigration Department, is the Canada Border Services Agency. This is the border security force of Canadian immigration of Canada overall. So these are sort of the immigration police, you can say. In other words, you can call them as the border guards, or you know, multiple slangs and multiple words in different countries, different parts of the world. But for Canada, they are known as the CBSA, and they play an important role in safeguarding our borders. And the CBSA officers are all concerned about the security of the Canadians, the permanent residents, who and the people who are currently inside Canada. So CBSA is the agency that takes care of that. CBSA and IRCC both work in tandem. They both work together towards securing the Canadian borders. Guys, the next important agency that you're looking at, or the next important place, the word is known as ICCRC. That's the Immigration Consultants of Canada, the Regulatory Council. So Immigration Consultants of Canada Regulatory Council is the place where we as RCICs, the Regulated Canadian Immigration Consultants, are registered with. We are members of ICCRC, and under the Immigration Refugee Protection Act, the IRPA, the Canadian Immigration Consultants, people like us, have gained recognition and we are authorized to represent our clients in applications at IRCC, CBSA, and you know, even in appeals as well. So ICCRC is the agency, is the place, or is the council that actually ensures that we as consultants all abide by the rules and the laws of Canadian immigration. Guys, the next important is Law Society of a particular province. So be it Law Society of Ontario or be it Law Society of any other province, So these law societies regulate the lawyers of Canada. So only three sorts of people are allowed to do Canadian immigration. First is an RCIC, so people like us who are members of ICCRC. Second is a paralegal, or third is a lawyer who is registered with a particular law society. So for example, so lawyers typically across Canada can do immigration, but paralegals only in some provinces can do immigration. So if you are dealing with any of these three people, they are they can be sitting anywhere across the globe, but then only these people are allowed to practice Canadian immigration and offer you help when it comes to your application being sent out to IRCC, sent out to CBSA, or even when lawyers can help you apply for certain federal applications. So guys, this is overall the backgrounder of how IRCC, of how immigration basically works inside Canada. But when it comes to applications, there are a few buckets when you can classify immigration into. The first is a temporary bucket. All temporary applications are also known as TRVs. So temporary resident visas, and that is the temporary category basically collectively holds all visit visas, all business visas, work permits, study permits, TRPs. So any visa, record or a permit, all of these categories fall into the TR. So basically temporary resident. So people who want to apply for temporary residence in Canada, these are the that's a bucket, and these are the applications that you can look at. When it comes to applying for a permanent residence, a number of applications or number of categories can be accounted for. The first is the economic classes, which basically holds the very famous express entry and the other economic classes applications as well. The second category is the family sponsorship. So if you are sponsoring any of your family member who can be outside Canada or even inside Canada, then your application will be sent for PR under the family sponsorship. There are provincial nominees as well, and then there are caregivers, there are startup visas, self-employed visas, and also then there are pilot programs, so like the AIPP, RNIP. So all of these applications put together form the PR bucket or the PR category or the permanent residence application for Canadian immigration. Okay, the third important category is refugees, the refugee protection inside Canada or outside Canada. So for Canadian immigration, any person who comes seeking for refuge, seeking for protection under the Canadian immigration, then Canada is happy to help these guys. So that forms a bucket of refugee protection. Then under IRCC or under the immigration applications, there is one more category, which is the citizenship. Citizenship, basically people who are permanent residents can apply for citizenship after a few years. So there are certain set of conditions that you need to qualify. So permanent residents can apply for citizenship, and this is the application that you must be applying under. The last and final is the appeals. If you are unhappy, or if you are finding that an immigration decision is unjust, is not as per what it should have been, and you have grounds for appeal, if you think there was something that was not done right, or if there was something that was overlooked or missing, then you can appeal a particular immigration decision. And even as foreign nationals, you can do that. You can file for a federal review, and it might get accepted, it might not, that's a separate question. But even if you are located outside Canada or if you are located inside Canada, you can still appeal for a particular immigration decision, and that particular opportunity is given to you by the immigration officer whenever he or she is either refusing or accepting a particular decision, and they will let you know whether you stand a chance for appeal or not. So guys, this is all for the whole bucket of immigration. When you do not know anything about immigration, this is where you can stand and see that what are the basic options that you might have, whether you want to come to Canada temporarily or permanently, or the other parts of immigration. So guys, once again, my name is Sahil, and if you want to reach out to me, my details are there in the description box and maybe on the screen right now. Please feel free to drop in a line and we will get back to you as soon as we can. Guys, all the best, and see you soon in Canada.